We're currently in the higher density planting. This planting was established to address future planting systems as laid out in the Almond Board of Australia's strategic investment plan for the next 5 years. The planting is 6.7 hectares in total. It's got almost 7,000 trees. We are evaluating desirable traits across three varieties, Australian bred varieties that are also self-fertile, planted on four rootstocks and at three planting distances, increasing the trees from 500 to 1,000 and also 2,000 trees per hectare. We are evaluating these different combinations for future planting systems when industry needs to move towards shake and catch harvesting. To enable us to fit a tree into an overhead harvester, which will potentially be the future shake and catch harvesting concept that they will develop, we need to keep the trees quite small, and for that reason we hedge it. So you will see we have quite a tight hedge to keep the interrow spacing open. It also limits the fruiting space that we will have. And as soon as you hedge the trees, you'll have vegetative growth. And we're evaluating all these traits of the different combinations to see how they react towards hedging, but also towards tree spacing. So we selected three Australian varieties, each with its own growth habit. Some of them are weeping, some of them are very upright, and some of them are very modular. We are evaluating four different rootstocks, two who are dwarfing, and two that is generally used in the almond industry. Because of the topography of the orchard, it's planted over a dune into a swale, which has very different readily available waters and also water holding capacity after irrigation. Each research plot is individually valved to not over or underwater any of the research plots, which would be an additional factor to be taken into consideration for yield prediction, etc., and for how the tree is responding to the three treatments.